Digital banking is not actually about offering banking services through internet or mobile. This is actually about becoming relevant to these new human behaviors that never existed before. Human beings are very good at transforming or creating a behavior which they enjoy doing, right? So YouTube, Facebook, WhatsApp, these are entertaining applications. Financial services, banking, money, payments, this is serious business. You know, bank is telling me, use your phone to transfer money. What if my phone is dropped in water? What if my phone screen breaks or somebody steals my phone? The perception is the money goes away as well because money is in the phone. First, understanding human behaviors and then changing human behaviors, it is about a design problem. I was part of the founding members of Easy Paisa. This over-the-counter money transfer is a big phenomenon. Before such service and offering, they used to send money to their homes through channels like bus drivers, who sometimes used to take some money out of their overall saving and charge a premium of taking this money. Or at times they had to take off from their work, go back to their home, give money, but then spend some time and spend some more money because they were meeting their families and friends. And eventually if they were visiting to transfer 15,000, they end up spending 3,000-4,000 in that festivity and resulting in having their family left with 11,000 rupees. Now we are talking about almost 50 million smartphones among 75 or 80 million persons, right? With probably 150 million SIMs in the market. So now that we have almost crossed 50% of the smartphone penetration, now is the time that the same businesses need to move forward and saying, let's do more good to you. Let me educate you of how you can, instead of going to a shop, do it yourself using your phone. And this is why you see this studio. This is a studio where we have anthropologists, we have artists, we have data scientists and some technology people as well. And this is a co-creation environment. This environment is designed to learn about human behaviors and test and create and test and create methods to transform the human behaviors. People with some financial background or technology background, right? When they came together, they started identifying opportunities in new human behaviors and new technology capabilities that they could literally offer as a service. So these companies, so fintech as a definition started from those startups who are offering financial services in one way or other. Banks over a period of time have evolved their technology and they're at a stage, largely speaking, where it is not easy to implement any idea or integrate with any idea. It is not about willingness or opportunity, it is about the complexity of technology and its integration. So yes, fintechs, if they have a very nice idea, they come to bank. Generally, banks appreciate and want to work and collaborate with them. The challenge is, banks have an ongoing business as usual and an ongoing product and service development roadmap. And they have a legacy architecture, which generally does not support the agility that these fintechs expect. Fintechs have realized that they cannot scale or grow beyond certain threshold because they need to comply to certain regulatory and people can only trust them so much. Banks have realized that they they are not designed to be agile. Hence, the digital lifestyle that a common customer is living and expecting that banks will be agile and will have an app or will have an experience that, you know, some of these digital companies are offering, like Snapchat or Google or Facebook. Banks now started to believe that we need to partner or collaborate with these fintechs. And vice versa, fintechs also started to believe that we need to work with banks to find a common ground of how we can make it a win-win.